What's going on, guys? Team Tech Gaming here, carrying on with our Let's Play Assassin's Creed 1. When we left off, we did have more to do than you can see now, but the video that I last recorded, which included viewpoints and save citizens, and I think one task, didn't record properly. I mean, you didn't really miss out on anything, so it's no big deal. Yeah, I'm sorry about that, guys. I'm going to have to carry on from this point here with what we've got left, which is two save citizens and two tasks. So, yeah, let's get right into it.
You dare steal in my presence? That will cost you your life. You dare steal in my presence? That will cost you your life.
You think you can outrun me?
Come on. I bet this is going to discount what I've just done, isn't it? That's going to refresh and there's going to be guards again.
Thank you. I'll find a way to repay this kindness.
He's in the tree. Right, next to our list, pickpocket. Shit. Pickpocket and interrogation. Yeah, I love interrogation. Alright, let's go this way then.
Stop! You must not trespass here!
Oh, come on, there's loads of them. Come on. I'm gonna hide in the niche in case guards come.
They let you come and go as you please. I thought the fortress was closed to all.
Aye, but William wishes to have repairs completed as soon as possible. It's been to our advantage.
The perfect cover. He's clever.
Anyway, I finished my report and should deliver it.
For once, it seems things might go our way, and not by accident.
Well, the Bible does say God helps those who help themselves.
Nah. It doesn't, actually. That's from one of Aesop's fables. The Bible says quite the opposite, in fact. Many passages of being patient and faithful and waiting for the Lord to decide if he wishes to assist.
Well, I say we've waited long enough.
You'll hear no argument from me.
Very well. I'm off, then.
Ridiculous.
Safe citizen. That looks like a temple.
Come on.
Oh, I've got a phone. And interrogation.
William of Montferrat and Edition. There's no way to end our pain. It's him we should follow. It's him will lead us to victory. Stand up, friends. Do not allow yourself to be set disordered based on the whims and wishes of an uncertain king. We must rely on men who are stronger in their convictions. Men like William of Montferrat.
Down the steps you go. And again. Pantaloons.
Stop! Enough! What is it you want? Gold? I've a few pieces on me. Take them. Take them and go.
It's not gold I seek, but information.
I know nothing.
You know William. Tell me how to reach him.
It's impossible. He meets with the king.
And when will the king be gone?
Today. But it won't help you. They're sure to argue, and then William will retire to lecture the soldiers. So it always goes. Richard berates William. William berates his men. He won't see you.
I already told you. I need to see William. I never said he needs to see me.
Then our business is done.
Not yet, I'm afraid. There's one last thing I need from you.
What is it?
Your life.
Right, now that we've done that, guys, that is all task viewpoints, save systems done, we are off to the Bureau Leader. And it's... I remember saying in one of my older videos that I thought...
This place is restricted.
That I thought William de Montferrat was my favourite assassination in Assassin's Creed 1. It's actually Sobran, I think it is. Wait, that's a good catch. Can't go that way then.
Why must he run around?
He's gonna hurt himself. And when he does, I won't help him.
Oh. There we go. That's where I wanted to go.
Word has spread of your deeds, Altair. It seems you are sincere in your desire to redeem yourself.
I do what I can.
And sometimes you do it well. I assume it is work that reunites us?
Yes. William of Montferrat is my target. I've done as asked and armed myself with knowledge. I know what I must do to reach him.
Speak, and I will judge.
William's host is large and many men call him master. But he's not without enemies. He and King Richard do not see eye to eye.
It's true, they've never been close.
This works to my advantage. Richard's visit has upset him. Once the king has left, William will retreat into his fortress to brood. He'll be distracted. That's when I will strike.
You're sure of this?
As sure as I can be. And if things change, I'll adapt.
Then I give you leave to go. End the life of Montferrat, that we may call this city free.
I always forget to take the feather.
I'll return when the deed's been done.
Fast forwarding memory to
a more recent one.
Off to kill William. Keep throwing knives out, guys, just in case there's any archers. It's a nice quick way to get rid of them. Ooh, you didn't mean to drop that. Up the ladder then. Not the flag, no more. Almost there. With a distance, this one.
Leave, peasant, before I make you.
And here we go. King Richard.
Three thousand souls, William. I was told they would be held as prisoners and used to barter for the release of our men.
The Saracens would not have honored their end of the bargain. You know this to be true. I did it for favor.
Oh, yes. A great favor indeed. Now our enemies will be that much stronger in their convictions. Fight that much harder.
I know our enemy well. They will not be emboldened, but filled with fear.
Tell me, how is it you know the intentions of our enemies so well? You who forsake the field of battle to play politics?
I did what was right, what was just.
You swore an oath to uphold the work of God, William. But that is not what I see here. No, I see a man who's trampled it.
Your words are most unkind, my liege. I would hope I might have earned your trust by now.
You are Arthur's regent, William, set to rule in my stead. How much more trust is required? Perhaps you'd like my crown.
You missed the point. This is nothing new.
Much as I'd like to waste my day trading words with you, I've a war to fight. We'll have to continue this another time.
Do not let me delay you then, your grace. I fear there will be no place for men like him in the new world. Send word that I wish to speak with the troops. We must ensure that everyone is doing their part. Warn them that any negligence will be severely punished. I'm in no mood to be trifled with today.
Yes, my lord.
The rest of you, follow me.
I think I'm doing more than trifling. Go. go.
Contributions to the cause.
For shame!
He knows nothing!
He's wrong!
Peace! Peace! Hold your tongue! Aye, he speaks falsely, but his words are not without some merit. The tour of these grounds, it is easy to find fault, to see imperfection. I fear we have grown slack and lazy.
Never!
We are committed!
Why do you say this?
I see the way you train. You lack conviction and focus. You gossip and gamble. Tasks set to you are left unfulfilled or poorly performed. This ends today. I will not suffer further degradation at his hands. For whether or not you see it, and you should, this is your fault. You've brought shame upon us all. Skill and dedication are what won us up, and they will be required to keep it. I have been too lenient, it seems, but no more. You will train harder and more often. If this means missing meat, missing sleep, so be it. But should you fail in these tasks, you will learn the true meaning of discipline. Bring them forward. If I must make examples of some of you to ensure obedience, so be it. The two of you stand accused of whoring and drinking while on duty. What say you to these charges?
My lord, please. We meant no harm by it. We forgot ourselves. It will not happen again.
No, it won't. Disregard for duty is infectious. It shall be rooted out and destroyed. In this way, we may prevent its spread. Am I understood?
Yes, my lord.
Of course, by your command.
Good, good. Return to your posts, filled with a new sense of purpose. Stay strong. Stay focused, and we will triumph. Falter, however, and you will join these men. Be sure of it. Dismissed!
Rest now. Your schemes are at an end.
What do you know of my work?
I know that you are going to murder Richard and claim Akka for your son Conrad.
For Conrad? My son is an arse, unfit to lead his host, let alone a kingdom. And Richard, the Oncino, is no better. Blinded as he is by faith in the insubstantial, Akka does not belong to either of them.
Then who?
The city belongs to its people.
How can you claim to speak for the citizens? You stole their food, disciplined them without mercy, forced them into service under you.
Everything I did to prepare them for the new world. Stole their food? No. I took possession so that when the lean times came, it might be rationed properly. Look around. My district is without crime, save those committed by you and your ilk. And as for the conscription, they were not being trained to fight. They were being taught the merits of order and discipline. These things are hardly evil.
No matter how noble you believe your intentions, these acts are cruel and cannot continue.
We'll see how sweet they are, the fruits of your labors. You do not free the cities as you believe, but rather damn them. And in the end, you'll have only yourself to blame. You. Who speak of good intentions.
That's another one to add to our list, William of Montferrat.
Close the gate!
Get out of here. Right, we're going to hold it there for this part, guys. When we come back, we're straight back to the Bureau Leader and then back to Admiral Allen to inform you of our progress. So stay tuned and I will see you in the next one.